Good evening, ma'am. How are you?
I'm good, Devika. How about you?
I'm good too. Would you like to introduce yourself?
Yeah, hi. I'm an independent counselor and parent of Samyukta. This is Sunita Anandakrishnan here. So thank you, Next Genius, for inviting me today to talk about my experiences with the Next Genius scholarship, because our complete family is a recipient of that scholarship. So we are thankful to it. Let me start with that.
Thank you so much, ma'am. That was a lovely...
I'm also an independent school counselor. I do counseling for local government school children, right from grade 7 and 8. And I have been doing some independent counseling for my daughter's classmates and for my son's classmates too.
That's amazing. Would you like to tell us, how did you first learn about the Next Genius Scholarship Program?
I think it was 4 years ago. We were applying for a few colleges. Just like any other parent, we drew upon some Ivy Leagues and we had applied to some state universities, which were in the top ranks, generally what parents do. But when we went for the interviews, Samyukta got selected for the interviews, second level, and financially, we were not unable to meet those expectations, because when we went to the admission counselors of the particular universities, they were very clear. For undergraduate, we do not provide any financial assistance. So we had no other choice, since she had dreams. We were thinking of what options do we have. So her school counselor, basically, she was pursuing her grade 12, full scholarship in a Singapore-based school. So school counselor, she came up with this, scholarship program from Next Genius. We found it was interesting. Yeah.
That was lovely to hear. Also with that, we would love to know how your experience with Next Genius has been over the past few years, continuing until today.
We have only been the recipient of the scholarship. No demand, I think. No expectations from the kids, from the parents, nothing. So down the line, 4 years, I wanted to, give back, me and my daughter wanted to give back something back to Next Genius, to what they provided the opportunity. Especially her dream of entering into engineering plus a liberal arts background. It was thrilling for all of us.
That's amazing. So moving forward, with Samyukta's experience herself, would you like to, mention to us about the umpteen opportunities given to, students during their time at college, right from their first year to their graduation, what all, resources they have access to, and how do they make the best of it?
Like NGSP said, they were very clear during the process of scholarship process. They said you need to have around 14 lakhs of rupees per year to, bear your living and, the cost, especially the food and living. They were very clear. So we had this vision of she's going to an engineering college with a liberal arts education. That was fantastic. But once she landed in Texas Christian University, under which she received a scholarship from NGSP. Within a month, she received, some kind of cultural connector program. And then with that, she got waived her complete meal plan. So that means 50% of her living expenses is completely waived off. And the local expenses also, she was very, very happy. She was able to manage with whatever she was getting there, and no additional funding from her parents. It was fantastic over there. This is, I'm saying, the financial part, which is a big concern for any other parents, Devika.
Yes, absolutely.
This is the main concern for each and every parent, which I think I have to address this issue. So almost 75% of her expenses were completely down within 8 months, completely borne by her. She was working as a grader, she was working as a tutor, and she was working for Starbucks.
Yes. So basically, students take access to all types of jobs on campus. And they definitely do not cover all of their living expenses, but it definitely, I would say, help them cover a lot.
75% of their expenses.
Yes. And initially,
do you think in India she can get this kind of opportunity? She wouldn't have gone out, worked somewhere, not worked as a grader, not worked as a tutor for the first year students.
Right.
This will impact a lot on the children, or I would say the students, interpersonal relationship. It works a lot.
I think that's the kind of exposure an international student gets from a liberal arts education.
Yes, you're absolutely right, Devika. On point.
So actually, this covers my next question, that, you know, how Samyukta has helped you, you know, in covering some portions of her living expenses, which I also believe from your conversation that international students do get a lot of support from their college community. Is it true?
Yes, they do get a lot of, support from the college community, especially if you get the opportunities as a resident advisor, especially you get your complete living and meal plan waived off. That means your 100% is being completely gone. It's free.
Right.
And you get to have lots of career services opportunities, get to have summer, internships. I think those are all great.
Okay. Again, I think, while we move forward with this conversation, I believe that, covering living expenses doesn't come naturally to a student. They have to put their foot forward and get involved into things, take a hold of opportunities, get behind it. And I believe Samyukta did it, and that's why she was able to avail these resources.
You're absolutely right. I always say to all the students I've been counseling, right from my children to other students, should have fire in your belly. Unless and until the fire is not burning in your belly, you wouldn't know how to survive in this world.
Yes.
And moving forward, we were talking about liberal arts, right?
Yes, liberal absolutely. Arts, what's on it?
Liberal arts help us to face all these contradictions which we are facing currently in the world, the insecurities, the unsure environment. How to tackle that? You're not really educated on one particular subject. Say if you take engineering, finance, you are having a complete broad knowledge on your writing skills, your communication skills. And on top of that, you'll be able to know which is wrong, which is right, ethics. So this is absolutely a dream come true for a upper middle class family. So for that, I'm really thankful, and I give my gratitude to Mr. Meerasam Mandana and NGSP for this opportunity, Devika.
Thank you, ma'am. It's actually very rejuvenating to hear from a scholar's parent, you know, the thoughts, because we feel that, there is so much that Indian parents need to know, because they are so worried about how and what will happen once the kid is on campus.
Yes.
So I'm sure this was a lot of insight into it. If you would like to add anything more, which was beyond my question.
Yes, I would also see this is not a rosy job. I wouldn't like to give you a rosy interview and then a rosy picture. Almost all the parents are working parents. If they're not working parents also, generally in office terms, we use the word, if anything happens or if anything is going to happen, we say it depends. I would say the same word here. It depends upon your child.
Right.
It depends upon the student. How the fire is burning in their belly. How they would like to mold their future.
Absolutely agree to you.
So this is the only wisdom, I would say. It all depends upon the students.
Yes. And any motivating words to students, students in grade 12 right now who are looking forward to apply to next year's 2021?
Focus on the world. Focus on what you're learning. It's not just the books you're going to learn. It is going to be an all-round development. Play music, learn the Bharatanatyam, learn Kuchipudi. You can do karate, taekwondo, The world is so big.
Yes.
You can accommodate anything. You can learn anything. So I would say it's a dream come true to apply through Next Genius, experience the world, and finally come back to India. And please grow India too. This is the only request I would say even to my children, to every others. Learn the best of the best and then come back and serve the community.
Thank you, ma'am. And I think I would like to add that the journey will always keep unfolding. So it's always how you begin and what is your vision?
Yeah, my vision is something like, as a mother, I would like my children to spread their wings, learn, come back to India, and then spread the same to others. But as a person who is in a community, I would say, do not keep yourself in a narrow-minded living. The world is so broad. So as your brain, it's a broad part. You can expand it as and when you want. So liberal arts definitely gives that perspective to the students, and the parents can also experience that through their children.
Absolutely agree to you. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you for your time.